Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Kyarlakkam CBC School Udol online classes. In previous class we discussed about distance formula and based on that we discussed first problem of exercise 7.1 and I told you to solve example problems and after that I told you to solve second and third problem in first main question of exercise 7.1. So I hope you solved those two examples and two problems from exercise 7.1, means second and third problem of first main question. If you got any doubt regarding these problems, you can contact me. So today I will continue with second problem of exercise 7.1. So here, what they have given? 7.1 second problem. Find the distance between points 0, 0 and 36, 15. Can you now find the distance between the two terms A and B discussed in 7.2? So first, here we will find out distance between these two points. For that, you know the formula, distance between two points equals to, what is that? Square root of x2 minus x1 whole square, square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So now we will consider these values as x2 and y2 and these values as x1 and y1. So here equals to x2 is 36, x1 is 0, so 36 minus 0 whole square plus y2 is 15, y1 is 0, therefore 15 minus 0 whole square. So now what we will get? 36 whole square plus 15 whole square. 36 minus 0 means 36 square plus 15 minus 0 means 15. Well, so now what is the value of 36 square? It is 1296. 36 square means 1296 plus 15 square means 225. 225. So now we have to add 1296 plus 225, means what we will get here? 1521. I will write it here directly. 1521. Square root of 1521 means 39 is the value. Square root of 1521 is 39. Is the answer. This is the distance between these two points. And now here in second question only, what they are asking again? Can you now find the distance between two terms A and B? So now what we will do? I'll write it here. Assume term A coordinates are 0, 0 and term B is 36, 15. So now this is the origin, means term A is the origin and term B is the destination. Coordinates of term A 0, 0 and here term B
36, 15. So as we solved here, distance between these two terms, distance between term A and B is, therefore, distance between term A and B is 39 kilometers. Okay. So now I'll move to the next problem, third one. What do I give here? Determine, third question. Determine if the points 1, 5, 2, 3 and -2, -11 are collinear. So now I will consider this 1, 5 as A and this 2, 3 is B and this is point C. So now I have to check whether these points are collinear or not. So now to check this, what we will do, first we will find out distance AB, and after AB we will find out BC. AB and after that BC, after that we will find out distance between AC or CA. So now if AB plus BC is equal to CA, if this AB plus distance between AB plus distance between BC is equal to CA, means distance between CA, then we can say that these points are collinear. If AB plus BC is not equal to CA, then these points are not collinear. So now AB is equal to, first we will calculate distance between point A and B. So now you know the formula. What is that? X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square. So now first we will consider here x1 y1 and x2 y2 values. So here I will write square root of 2 minus 1 whole square, 2 minus 1 whole square plus 3 minus 5 whole square, 3 minus 5 whole square. Means what we will get here, 2 minus 1 means here this is x1 and x2, y1 and y2, therefore 2 minus 1 whole square plus 3 minus 5 whole square. 2 minus 1 means we will get 1, and 2 minus 1 means 1, 1 square means what we will get here, 1 square means 1, plus 3 minus 5 means what is it, 3 minus 5 means plus into minus minus, we have to subtract, therefore 5 minus 3, 2 is the answer, and the sign in front of higher value is minus, therefore minus 2 will get, 3 minus 5 means what we will get, minus 2. And here minus 2 whole square means what we will get, minus 2 into minus 2 means plus 4, therefore minus 2 whole square means we will get plus 4. 1 plus 4 means square root of 5 is the distance between point A and B. So now again distance between B and C, again we will consider this formula only, and here I will write, now I will consider these two as x1 y1 and these two are x2 y2. So now what you can write here, minus 2 here, x2 minus 2 x1 minus 2 whole square plus y2 is minus 11 and minus 3 whole square. So now minus 4 minus 2 means minus into minus plus, therefore 2 plus 2 4, and minus 4 you will get minus 4 whole square means what you will get? Minus 4 whole square means 16. Because minus 4 into minus 4 means 4 into 4 16, minus into minus plus, therefore 16 is the answer. So now minus 11 minus 3, minus 11 minus 3 means what you will get? Minus 14. Minus 14 whole square means what you will get? Here I will write directly. Minus 11 minus 3 means you will get minus 14. Minus 14 whole square means minus 14 into minus 14. So answer is 196 plus 196 answer. So now 16 plus 196 means what you will get? 16 plus 196 means 212 is the answer. This is the length of BC. So now again we consider CA. So here, now we will consider these two values as x1, y1, and these two are x2, y2. So here, minus 2, minus 1 whole square plus your minus 11, minus 5 whole square. These two are x1, y1, and here x2, y2. Sorry. X2, Y2. So now either you can consider these two as X2, Y2, sorry, these two as X2, Y2 and X1, Y1. We will get same answer. Why? Because there is square root. We will get same answer. You can consider this as X1, Y1 or X2, Y2, or you can consider this as X1, Y1 or X2, Y2. In both cases you will get same answer only. So here what I did, here I considered these two values as x1, y1, minus 2 and minus 11. These two are x2, y2, sorry, x2 minus y2. Therefore, these two considered as x2, y2 here in third case. And here these two are considered as x1, y1. Okay? You may consider these two as x1, y1 and these two you can consider as x2, y2. In both cases you will get same answer. So now here what I did, listen carefully, I considered these two values as x2, y2 and these two are x1, y1 here. Or you may consider this as x1, y1 and these two as x2, y2. In both cases you will get same answer because there is square. So you will get same answer. So now minus 2 minus 1 whole square means what you will get? Minus 2 minus 1 means what you will get first? Minus 2 minus 1 means we will get here minus 3. Minus 2 minus 1 means minus 3. Minus 3 whole square means what you will get? 9. Because minus 3 into minus 3 means what you will get? 9. So now minus 11 minus 5. So minus 11 minus 5 means minus 16 is the answer. Minus 16 square means what you will get? Minus 16 square means minus 16 into minus 16. So we will get plus 256. Plus 256. 9 plus 256 means 265. Square root of 265. So now we will check whether AB plus BC is equal to CA or not. So now what is AB value? Root 5. And BC value is square root of 212 equals to CA value is 265. So here root 5 plus root 212 is not equal to root square root of 265. So we can write here this AB plus BC is not equal to CA. Therefore, points are not collinear. Therefore, you should write here, points are not collinear. This is the answer for the third question.
So now, in fourth question, what I have learned, check whether 5, minus 2, 6, 4 and 7, minus 2 are the vertices of an isosceles triangle. So there are given three vertices here. I will consider that these vertices as A, B, C. A is 5, minus 2 and B is 6, 4 and C is 7, minus 2. 5, minus 2, 6, 4, 7, minus 2. These are the three points we have given, A, B, C, and we have to check whether these are vertices of an isosceles triangle. So now we will find out distance between AB and BC and CA. And we all know that isosceles triangle means two sides are equal to each other in a triangle. So if any of two sides are equal, it may be AB, BC or CA, in these three sides, any of two sides are equal to each other, then we can say that these vertices are of isosceles triangle. So first we will find out distance between AB. So now we will consider formula x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So now what is x2 here? 6, and x1 is 5. Therefore, square root of 6 minus 5 whole square, 6 minus 5 whole square plus 4 minus of minus 2, because here y2 is 4, here it is minus, and y1 value is minus 2 only. Therefore, you should write minus 2, minus of minus 2. Why? Y2 is 4, minus you should write here, and y1 value is minus 2, therefore 4 minus of minus 2 whole square. So here 6 minus 5 means what you will get? 1. So 1 square means what you will get here? 6 minus 5, 1. 1 square means 1 is the answer, because 1 into 1 will get 1 only. And now minus into minus plus, therefore 4 plus 2. So 4 plus 2 means minus into minus, what you will get? Plus. So 4 plus 2 whole square equals to square root of 1 plus 4 plus 2, 6. 6 square means 36 is the answer. 1 plus 36 means what we will get? Square root of 37. So now we will find out length of BC. And another most important thing is that you can consider this as x1, y1 or this as x1, y1. If you consider this as x1, y1, this is x2, y2. If you consider this as x1, y1, this will be x2, y2. So in both cases, you will get same answer, because there is square value. So when you square that value, you will get same answer only. So here we will get same answer for both cases, square root of 37. Now for BC, now I will consider these two values as x1, y1, and here it is x2, y2. So square root of 7 minus 6 whole square plus minus 2 minus 4 whole square. Minus 2 minus 4 whole square is equals to square root of
7 minus 6 means 1, and 1 square means what you will get here?
1.
And now minus 2 minus 4 means what you will get? Minus 2 minus 4 means minus 6. Minus 6 square means minus 6 into minus 6, what you will get? Plus 36.
So 36 is the answer. 36 plus 1 square root of 37.
Now again we will find out CA. So here I will consider this as x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. The square root of x2 minus x1 means 5 minus 7. 5 minus 7 whole square plus y2 minus y1. y2 is minus 2 and y1. y2 minus y1 is minus 2. Therefore, minus of minus 2. So here you should be careful. When there is a minus value, you should first consider minus here, because what is the formula? Y2 minus y1 whole square. In formula only you have minus here, y2 minus y1. So here after writing y2, y2 value is minus 2, here I have done minus 2. Y2 value is minus 2, after that minus is there in formula. So first we should write minus here, after that y1, what is the y1 value here? Minus 2. So here you should write minus 2. Therefore what it becomes? Minus of minus 2 whole square. So now here 5 minus 7 means, 5 minus 7 means plus into minus minus. So 7 minus 5 means 2. So and sign in front of higher value is minus. Therefore minus 2 is the answer, and minus 2 square means what you will get? Minus 2 into minus 2, 4. Minus 2 square means 4. So now here minus 2 minus into minus. So first I will write this plus in bracket minus 2 minus into minus plus. Therefore here I will write plus 2 whole square. Minus 2 plus 2 means what you will get? Minus 2 plus 2 means 0 only. So 0 square means 0. Here square root of 4 means what will get? Answer 2. So now what you got to know here? AB and BC, these two sides are equal to each other. So here in isosceles triangle always two sides are equal to each other. Therefore these three points are vertices of an isosceles triangle. 5, minus 2, 6, 4, 7, minus 2 are the vertices of isosceles triangle. Here you can write AB is equal to BC. AB is equal to BC because both are equal to square root of 37 only. Therefore AB is equal to BC. Therefore these three points are vertices of isosceles triangle. So I hope you all are clear with these three these first four problems. In next class I will continue with fifth problem. Thank you all.